For the chicken momos, I have about 500 grams of minced chicken, ginger garlic paste, 1 whole teaspoon, spring onion greens, salt, pepper, 2 medium-sized onions finely chopped, 1/4 cup of chopped coriander, 1 to 2 teaspoons soy sauce. I'm going to mix all these ingredients together. Add 1 tablespoon of oil and mix it all together. So once you've mixed all this together, just keep it aside. So for the dough, I'm taking 1 cup of maida, all-purpose flour. Add a little salt, a little oil, a little water. Knead it for 5 minutes till you get a nice, soft, pliable dough. Take a little of the dough. This would be an ideal size. You just roll it out flat. You can see I've rolled it out nice and flat and thin. I'm going to place a bit of the chicken mince. This is the filling, the center. I'm going to start folding it in. This is a key here. Fold it from one end and start folding in. From one end, you can seal it. Press it nicely so they seal. There you have. It's perfectly good and large. Momos, chicken momos are ready. So this is a momo steamer. If you don't have this, you can use an idli steamer or you can use a pressure cooker, whatever works for you best. But you need to have a tray with these little perforations so that the steam can come up. So I'm going to close this and wait for the water to boil. I'm just going to grease this tray, take a little oil. Place the momos in the steamer. You can make smaller ones like these if you like. Steam cook the momos for about 20 to 25 minutes. The momos are done. They've been steam cooked for about 25 minutes. They're done. Turn off the stove and you can serve it with some nice momo chutney. So there you have these absolutely delicious chicken momos. So do try them and enjoy them. I've also made the chutney for the momos. You can get that recipe as well. For the tomato chili chutney, we're going to blanch a few ingredients, about 8 dry red chilies. I'm going to boil that in hot water. So I'm just going to blanch the tomatoes. Take a small saucepan, add a teaspoon of oil. Add the blanched tomatoes, just roughly chopped it. 2 cloves of garlic and 1 piece of ginger. Blanched red chilies, just adding a little salt. Add 1/2 teaspoon of sugar to balance the flavors. So this is a very simple momo chutney. I'm sure people have different variations to it, but I'm just making a very simple one. Cook it for 2 minutes and turn off the stove. Check for seasoning. Cool the mixture completely and then grind it. Add a few coriander leaves and just grind it together. So there you have the simple and spicy chutney that you can have when you make your momos. We're just going to make the dough first. I've taken 1 cup of all-purpose flour or maida, 1/2 teaspoon salt, add about 2 teaspoons of oil, and gradually start pouring the water till you get a nice pliable dough. So knead the dough for about 5 minutes. Let it sit for about 30 minutes. So if we're going to make the filling for the momos, for that take a white saucepan, add 1 tablespoon of oil, 1 onion, large onion finely chopped, a few cloves of garlic finely chopped, a piece of ginger finely chopped. Once the onions are transparent, piece of capsicum that's finely chopped, 1 carrot that's been finely grated, 1/2 of a cabbage that's been finely grated. It's a medium-sized cabbage, taken 1/2 portion of that, it's grated fine. Season it with salt, teaspoon of pepper. I'm adding a teaspoon of vinegar, dark soy sauce, 1 teaspoon. Finally, add some chopped coriander leaves to finish off. The filling is done. Turn off the stove, cool the mixture, and then we're going to start making the momos. The dough is nice and soft, you can see. Now we're going to start rolling it out to make the momos. Take a little bit of the dough, roll it to the side. Take very little of the dough, roll it out flat. Just keep a little bit of the filling in the center and start folding gently. You can see we're going to make small pleats. So hold it together, start the pleats on one end and gently start making the pleats. Close it, just twirl it. So we're going to make another shape, like a crescent shape. So first starting, just make the pleats on one side. The next step is to seal the folds. I've pressed it nicely, press it nice and hard. Make sure it's completely sealed. So just going to make another shape here. So start making the pleats. And just fold it in. Steam it for about 10 minutes. There you have this absolutely delicious, soft and steaming vegetable momos. Do try it and subscribe to our YouTube channel and also follow us on Facebook and Instagram. You can get a copy of our first edition of the home cooking book on Amazon and 21 Frames.